You're a falling star. You're the getaway car. You're the line in the sand when I go too far. You're the swimming pool on an August day. And you're the perfect thing to say. And you play it coy, but it's kinda cute. Oh, when you're smiling at me, you know exactly what you do. Baby, don't pretend, but you don't know it's true. Cause you can see it when I look at you. And in this crazy life. You're every word, you're everything. You're a carousel, you're always so well. And you light me up when you ring my bell. You're a mystery, you're from outer space. You're every minute of my everyday. And I can't believe that I'm your man. And I get to kiss you, baby, just because I can. Whatever comes our way, I will see it through. And you know that's what our love can do. And in this crazy life, and through these crazy times, it's you, you make me sing. You're every line, you're every word, you're everything. You're everything. You're every song, and I sing along. Cause you're my everything.
Flower Girl, big round of applause for Milan Vaughn. Right behind him, we've got Alyssa and Anthony, also Avery. How about a big round of applause for Nolan and Molly? And right behind them, we've got Catherine and Colin. And at this time, folks, I need you all on your feet. Go and run this for me. Let's start top those hands with feet, come on. There we go. Big round of applause for the stars of tonight's show. Let's hear it for Mr. and Mrs. Jared and Reed.
Oh,
Oh, yes, let's hear for that first dance. Another big round of applause. Come on. Dancing with the stars, you got nothing on them right there. That was beautiful.
Before knowing you, I would have asked you in this speech to take care of my sister. But knowing you now, there is no doubt in my mind that you will. For my sister, darling, my best friend, I'm so happy for you. Last year brought some amazing, amazing accomplishments. You graduated from law school, landed a competitive internship, and passed the bar. Now you begin 2014 with a wedding. I know there's still some amazing accomplishments ahead for you, and I'm going to be so blessed to be witness to all of it. Thank you for being an amazing sister, for always being supportive, like in the times you've always agreed to sing backup to my performances, for being so generous, like in the time you gave me your Cinderella Barbie that you got for your birthday, after I cried for it. For always being my voice of reason, for being the most wonderful tita to baby Mila. For all the adventures, and for all the laughs. I love you so much. I tried to think of a poignant toast fitting for this moment, but I thought it best that I leave that toast to two of the most insightful people I know.
Good evening, everybody. In case you don't know us, my name is Colin.
And I'm Nolan, and we are Jared Sender Brothers. We're glad everyone could make it here. Thank you so much, Shino. A lot of you guys traveled pretty far, so we appreciate it. We're glad that you're here to celebrate Jared Sender's wedding.
Now, even though our mother says that she loves us all just the same, as the first, Jared was always the golden child. He probably underestimates just how much we both looked up to him growing up. When we were kids, we both played on Pee Wee football for several years together. Jared was a natural leader, and he ran the team as our quarterback. I always remember one afternoon on St. Peter's football field when he threw me a touchdown pass. He was always setting us up for success, whether it be by being a good teammate or by setting an example as our older brother. And you couldn't ask for more for a big brother.
As great as Jared is, we found that Sarah has improved in many ways. Since Jared and Sarah started dating, I think we've all seen a change in Jared's sense of humor. Much to Sarah's chagrin, me and Jared went skydiving in San Diego in his last days before being married. After we touched down from 13,000 feet, Jared came up to me. He looked at me and said, "You're like a brother to me." Jared, we'll always be like brothers. Anyway, I'm so happy you found Sarah and you found someone that you could enjoy this last with.
Yeah. We knew that Sarah was going to be a good fit when she showed such great interest in the family. She liked to ask a lot of questions. To get to know just about everything about everyone. And although it seemed like a bit of an interrogation at times, that's how we know she really cares.
You guys have supported each other through a lot. Try not to cry. You know, you made it through law school, you made it through med school. You guys are both amazing individually, and together you're even stronger. We couldn't be happier for you both. We're proud of everything you've accomplished together, and we look forward to watching you guys grow as a couple. So Sarah, welcome to the family. We've always wanted a sister.
So please join us in raising your glasses to Jared and Sarah. We love you both just the same. Cheers.
I want to thank Anne for that roast. That was wonderful. At this time, folks, the wonderful staff here at 7 Degrees is going to start serving your dinner. When it's your turn to eat, enjoy your meal.
When he and Sarah were attending Georgetown together, and he's grown to be a very special part of our family. He and Sarah, along with our other daughter and son-in-law, have taken family vacations together from Puerto Rico, where Jared confided in us that he'd like to go on a horse today. Go to Palomino, right, Jared? To Mexico City, where he impressed us with his Spanish-speaking skills. And Spain. And Spain, where we saw a flamenco show, and he showed a deep interest in dance, and he demonstrated part of that tonight, right? And lots of other places in between, including Las Vegas and our mutual fondness of a drink they serve there called Octane. But we won't elaborate on that, right? But stay in Las Vegas.
TMI.
In all the time we've known Derek, he's always shown us to be a respectful, humorous, and very humble young man, a very admirable attribute. Sarah, well, we've known her all her life. She was a very quiet child growing up. She hardly said a word until she was around 5 years old. Then it seems as if overnight she made up for all those quiet years. She couldn't stop talking or asking questions. Daddy, how does that work? Daddy, where are we going? Daddy, when will we get there? Daddy, why do you look that way? Is everything okay? She is still and always be to me that little girl asking the same old questions. Looking back, I guess she did choose the right profession for her. I know she'll make an excellent attorney. I said in another very special wedding, a little more than 2 years ago, that our children are our legacy, and we will leave on this planet. And I couldn't be prouder of Jared and Sarah. What they have both achieved academically and in preparation for the professions gives my wife and I such pride and great peace of mind that they will see all the things in the world and do all the things that they enjoy doing, that someday Jared might own that work. He's been wishing. Lastly, my advice to you both is that marriage is about give and take, meeting in the middle. Always think before you say something you regret. Don't get a bit mad at each other. And put your significant other first before thinking of yourself. Now let's all raise our glasses and wish for Sarah and Jared many years of good health, happiness, and prosperity.
You're here. First off, let me start off by congratulating Jared and Sarah. As some of you may not know me, I'll start with an introduction. I'm Anthony Bellotto. And as Sarah recently described me, I'm the anchor groomsman. I haven't had the pleasure of knowing these two for as long as some others who have known you for your entire lives, or some of you may have known from high school, but I'm close to 2009, where I've known you for your entire Georgetown career, practically. My friendship with the happy couple dates back to 2006, the beginning of my senior year at Georgetown. It was then that I moved into Kennedy 4 with a group of runners and Jared's group of friends. Jared's group was rather difficult to integrate into, having been so tight-knit on Harbin 9, which is known as the skyscraper, or what? What is it? Anyway, the very top is the highest room available at the penthouse. Slowly, I was welcomed into the fold and started eating meals in the cafeteria with them, even though I missed a few text messages here and there. It wasn't until that time that Jared and I realized we had a lot in common from pre-med and other interests, and we realized we're gonna be friends for a long period of time. So I'd like to say that Jared and I became friends more gradually, but Sarah and I were rather abrupt. I met Sarah during one of my Sunday morning laundry sessions, as Sarah will remember. As a student guard, the small, petite, slight-framed Sarah was to guard the entire campus community from thieves, mobsters, and stray dogs that roamed Georgetown's campus early on Sunday mornings. It was one such morning that our paths crossed, and I didn't have my go-kart with me. And as my luck would have it, an actual campus guard was watching. You can't go back into the dorm, you don't have your go-kart. But Sarah, without skipping a beat, said, "Oh, I know him. He lives in the building. He has some of my classes with me. Go on ahead." So I didn't hesitate, went upstairs. But when I came back down, I came down to thank her and saw her watching an episode of Lost, and we realized we had a lot more in common than just her letting me break into my building that I lived in. From Lost and Avatar and other things like dancing, ballroom, and my Irish set dancing. It was after becoming friends with both that I started to blur my friendship groups together. What were separate daily gym sessions with Jared and occasional dinners with Sarah evolved into long, late-night study sessions at the illustrious Table of Knowledge in the bowels of Lounger. While Jared and Sarah may recite the pool story, as the first time they met, and the sparks flew. I will tell you a lesser known origin story that I think is when the sparks actually flew. One night, I invited them both over for a movie night and dinner. We made dinner and baklava, which I hope you're enjoying at your table, from scratch. Had a little bit of Justin Timberlake's favorite red wine and watched Love Actually. It was this night when Sarah first started to teach Jared how to dance that I believe the sparks really began to fly and the love story that is Jared and Sarah really took off. And as evidence from tonight's splendid performance, it's matured beautifully and aged well like a good wine over the years. I won't bore the audience with all the memories shared amongst the three of us, from inside jokes of meat excursions in North Carolina and fresh ice cream, to missing connecting flights and being stranded in Las Vegas, to drugging ourselves with a touch of Tylenol PM, or even the delirium of a midnight ride to Hotlanta for the Final Four, the Motel 6, the Dollar Store Pelican, or the infamous parking lot. And how could I forget the hallway house with Jean-Claude Balsette? And the too hot, too cold apartment with the unfinished patio that wasn't finished until a week before we moved out, and oh, freezing ourselves at inauguration. I feel that something everyone can relate to about Sarah and Jared is their generosity, compassion, and selflessness. I'll end with one final story, which involves my cat Gatsby, who would have been homeless for an entire year had Jared and Sarah not stepped up and adopted him for nearly 12 months. This kind of act of offering to open up their home without hesitation in North Carolina truly speaks volumes of their loyalty, friendship, and generosity. I want you both to know that words can't express my gratitude for your friendship these last 7 years, and what your friendship both individually and together has meant to me, and how both of you have really enriched my life. I will always cherish the memories that we've created together and look forward to making new ones in the years to come. Please join me in raising a glass to the happy couple. No, I don't have one. To Jared and Sarah.
You know, I was wondering, you know, if you could keep on, because the force, it's got a lot of power, and it makes me feel like it makes me feel like.
Songs yet remains to be sung. Cheers.
you know, right after we throw this bouquet, we're going to do a group photo, and that's with everybody. Everyone's going to be coming out here in just a moment. So don't throw it too high, but don't throw it too low and hard. And don't hit the little flower girl. There you go. On the count of three, here it is. One, two, three, go. There we go. Perfect. Yeah. There you go. We got it.